afternoon, everyone. Good afternoon, Ms. Lilo and Mrs. Abante. We are here today to present to you our research proposal. Let me just introduce myself and my co-members. I am Kyla Shane Rose Cabrera, and here is Mr. De Castro, Mr. Tugawen, Ms. Babasa, and Ms. Ortega. Our research proposal is entitled Solid Waste Disposal and its effect to the health of the household members. As we all know, human waste can contribute to the significance of health to the community, especially to the environment. Lack of awareness and low income sources makes the residents live with unhealthy and unhygienic conditions. By having waste management, it is intended to reduce the effect of waste on health. For the statement of the problem, here is Jericho De Castro.
Thank you, Ms. Cabrera. So, as she said, I am Jericho De Castro, and I will discuss to you the statement of the problem of our study. Then, me and my groupmates, as the researchers, we aim to know what are the effects of having solid waste disposal on the barangay that we are assigned, which is the Barangay Kalansayan, San Jose, Batangas. And we also have to gather some information from the residents' experiences on having this kind of problem, and we also intend to know, or we also want to find some processes that we can give or suggest to the barangay to prevent having those kind of problems about the waste and for them to become safe. We think that our study will have a great contribution for the barangay because we can, from their answers, we can make some preventions. And next to the statement of the problem is the significance of our study, which will be discussed by Ms. Paula Babasa.
Thank you, Mr. De Castro. For the significance of the study, our study will help the people in the community to be educated on how the solid waste management will affect their health and how to prevent it from happening. It will also increase the people's awareness about solid waste management. This study will also help the future researchers to know more about on how solid waste management will affect the health of the community. Furthermore, this will also be a motivation for the barangay officials to focus more on how waste management program. For the scope and the limitation, I will now give the floor to Mr. Tugawen.
Thank you, Ms. Babasa.
Yes.
Our study focuses mainly on how solid waste disposal affects the health of the household members in Barangay Kalansayan, San Jose, Batangas. Our study did not include other barangays and communities in San Jose, Batangas. Our study is conducted to know the further effects of how solid waste disposal affects the health of the household members in Barangay Kalansayan, San Jose, Batangas. Our study is based on waste management theory. And to further understand about our theory, this theory, here's Ms. Babasa.
Thank you. This study was based accordingly to the waste management theory, which is concerned on how people interpret about their environment and how health affects each one of us. Waste management theory by Pongras, Phillips, and Kiske is established on the desire on how waste management will prevent the waste. This will cause harm to the human as well as nature. This study will be beneficial for us because this will help us improve the method on the waste management theory that we could apply as soon as possible to the residents of Barangay Kalansayan, San Jose, Batangas. For some of the terms that are conceptually and operationally defined in our study, for the better understanding of the reader, here is
Babasa. Here are the definition and terms of our study. First is the contemporary migrants, decentralized, hazardous, incinerators, legislation, up and downside, primitive place, and speculation, and the last one is waste. Contemporary migrants are people that live or go in other country in order to find work. Centralized. Hazardous. Perilous or full of waste. Incinerators are large containers that incinerate waste materials. Legislation is an act of or making of laws. And open dumpsite are landfills that waste are thrown. Primitive place. The earliest of the kind or in existence. Speculation is an act of trading in an asset. And the last one is waste. Things that I need to be thrown away or need to be disposed of. Let us now have Ms. Cabrera for the related studies of our research.
There are some of the related literature in our study. First, in the study entitled Management of the Solid Waste in Nigeria, it states that financial control and lack of appropriate technologies are the major challenges to the waste disposal of the country. According to Servastra, there is an increase in global population that making the waste increase. And according to Servastra, there is an increase in global population and the rising interest for food and different fundamentals, which has been a rise in the amount of waste being created day by day by every family or compound. By having this set, it could lead to the infectious diseases. The study of Salam Abul states that solid waste disposal sites are found on the outskirts of the urban areas that turns into the child sources of contamination due to the reproduction of flies, mosquitoes, and rodents that are disease transmitters that could affect the health that could affect the population itself. For the synthesis of our study, here is Mr. Derek Abecastro.
Thank you again, Ms. Cabrera. And now, let me discuss to you the synthesis of our study. So, after getting and collecting information and answers from the respondents, we learned that having solid waste disposal or solid waste in their barangay is making a huge effect about the health of the every household members, especially the kids or the children, and also it can damage their environment. We learned that from their answers, the people whose houses are near the depository sites or open dam sites are the ones who are at the very high risk of having the common sickness that everyone is encountering or experiencing on their daily life inside the Barangay Kalansay, San Jose, Batangas. And we also create that the proper manage of solid waste disposals would be the very best health for them to keep their environment healthy and also the people and make their lives more happy. And we will now move to the chapter 3 of the research methodology, which will be discussed to you by Ms. Vanessa Ortega.
Raw material design is likely to begin with question or even just a collection of qualitative data.
the more data is to be collected and reviewed, codes can be grouped into concepts and categories. Our study became grounded theory design as we first collected the qualities of the issues, which is the solid waste management, and the explanations and information of the respondents has been grouped into categories for us researchers to identify their perspectives about this issue. So for the respondents, let's have Ms. Babasa.
Thank you, Ms. Ortega. For the researchers' respondents, it is the concerned citizens living in Barangay San Jose, in Barangay Kalat Sayan, San Jose, Batanes.
And for the instruments, us researchers use or prepared some questions for the respondents to answer. And we use a face-to-face interview to gather some data, and our questions is all about environment between the respondents. And some of our questions are, what or how will you dispose your waste, and what can you give in your community to improve? So their answers is important for us because we need to know their comments and opinions that will help us or to guide us in this study. Thank you for listening. It is the end of our presentation. We hope that you accept our research proposal. The floor is now open for your recommendations and questions.
We are proposing a seminar.
I don't know. What are you proposing to us? What do you want to research on?
We would like to research on about the effects of waste to the community, because nowadays there has been an increase in the global warming, as I saw in the internet, and pollution, and we would like to have a research on that.
So effects of waste.
Yes.
Why do you want to research on that?
Because every community and barangay are having a lot of problems pertaining to the lack of proper manage on the waste disposal.
You were saying that you would want to research about the effects of waste. So why am I hearing waste disposal?
Because these waste are the ones who are affecting the health and the environment of the community.
So what's the connection with the waste disposal?
If we don't know how to manage our waste, our health can be damaged. Like, we can get a lot of disease from them. So that's why we want to know the effects for us to be able to be aware in proper waste management.
So what you would want to study on is the effects of waste on the barangay Kalansayan,
yes.
But not the waste disposal.
Yes.
So in terms on the effects of waste, you mentioned that it has effect on health. What else do you still want to talk about there?
We will just focus on the health of the household members in Barangay Kalansayan.
So why in the presentation I had seen waste management theory? What is it all about? How is it connected to the effects of waste?
Waste management theory is how people interpret the environment and how it affects the health of each one of us.
What is affecting each one of us? The waste management or the waste?
The waste.
But the waste management theory talks about waste only,
yes.
Not how to manage waste.
About the waste and how it would affect the health of
okay. Who is the source and what year? Okay. In the definition of terms, why did you define contemporary migrants?
Contemporary migrants are people who go to other country and live there so they can find work.
Yeah. So why did you define it? In what part of your
contemporary migrants were written in the related literature. So we got that word to further understand that meaning because we would like to make an
okay. So what's the role of contemporary migrants in the effects of waste?
We consider that those contemporary migrants might be, or they can add some waste, or they can add some waste that can cause pollutions to the environment or community or country that they are.
So example, in our case, we're not from Barangay Kalansayan. Can we consider ourselves as contemporary migrants that would still contribute to the waste in the barangay?
Yes.
In the respondents, you mentioned that you would want the concerned citizens. How would we characterize the concerned citizens?
It is the concerned citizens about the solid waste management living in Barangay Kalansayan.
What do you mean concerned? So concerned citizens, what do you mean by that? Are they the ones using the what? What do you mean by concerned citizens?
We conducted an interview and we asked about their common problems in their barangay and we get that from their answers.
And who are the concerned citizens?
The people living in barangay.
So anyone. So why do we have to use concern? Can we not use citizens of the barangay? Why do we have to put the word concern?
Based from their answer that they need, that they
management regarding the solid waste.
They need concerned citizens.
I mean, they are the ones who are concerned with their communities because they are the ones who are affected by the waste. Are not being properly disclosed by
so the concerned citizens there refer to those who were affected by the improper waste. Well, I still have a lot of questions, but it will just lead me to confusion if I will ask them. So I'll just stick with what you had said, that you would want to study about the effects of waste to the citizens of Barangay Kalansayan.
Instead of having more respondents because of the time given to us and because of the letter. Thank you.